Hello gorgeous people, welcome back to my YouTube. I've had a ridiculous amount of comments asking me how I do my heatless curls, so I thought that I would do a super quick, easy tutorial to show you how I do them. As some of you may know, I do have really long hair. So for me, kind of doing my hair, curling it normally will probably take me about anything from 45 minutes to an hour. So the fact that I can literally, they take me 5 minutes to do, I'm gonna show you, sleep in them and then wake up and they're the most gorgeous curls is a dream for me. And I honestly do them like almost every night. This is the length of my hair. I am actually using a set from Rehab Your Hair, which is just one that I use. I was sent it a while ago. It's honestly a godsend. It is the best set. And it also comes with these like little oil capsules, but I haven't got them right now. But this is the brush that it comes with. It's also like the spring brush, which I love because as I'm brushing through my hair, which you wanna do before you do heatless curls, it just means that I haven't got any pulling because obviously if anything tugs, if there's any knots, the spring will just kick in and then it won't actually give you those split ends on the bottom. It's just nice and soft and gentle on your hair. So I do actually go for this one. It just happened to be in the same set as the heatless curls. As you can see, I started by brushing my hair thoroughly all the way through. This is really important because as you're wrapping your hair up, you don't want to be wrapping knots into it. It's just going to make it really difficult to unwrap in the morning. And then next, I've just gone ahead and I've sectioned it right down the center. And I'll just show you from the back so you can see. Straight down the middle like that, so we're able to start twisting. And again, now I'm in two sections, I am just going to brush through and make sure that there are literally no knots from where I've kind of played with it by separating it. And just make sure that you're pretty thorough here, checking that you have got everything very central. My parting does sit to the side and I kind of like a curl this side, so I will leave it slightly off center, but that just works for me. Obviously, if you leave it where your parting is, you could end up having more hair this side, but if it is literally just your face frame that's uneven and the rest is down the center, that should be fine. Next step, this is really important because it's going to help you to keep your curls nice and tight, is you're going to need a clip. This set from Rehab Your Hair did actually come with a really cute little nude clip, but I haven't got that one on me right now. It's probably just in my room somewhere. And I'm just popping it on, clip it just so it's got enough hair they can hold on, but not that it takes up too much hair, because obviously we need to get everything wrapped in. And just make sure that your two sides are even. The set that I have also comes with two silk scrunchies, and I like to just make sure I've got these on my wrists ready for when I'm wrapping, so I'm not kind of fumbling around trying to find the hairband. This is also another super important point. So many people ask me, do you do this on dry or damp hair? Now I have ridiculously thick hair that will hold moisture for hours. Like I had a shower last night, it's now the morning, I'm doing this obviously tutorial for you guys in the morning, and my hair is still damp. So I know that this is a pretty good time for me. If not, I'll probably have my shower in the morning and then I'll wait until the evening, because my hair is just so thick that it will hold moisture for hours, meaning that the curls just won't fully dry. Obviously, if you have thinner hair, you can kind of have a shower, maybe wait a few hours, let it dry down till it's almost completely dry, but it just has that little bit of moisture in it. That is the best for me, because you're not going to wake up with damp hair. The curls will just drop out if your hair is still damp. Obviously, if your hair is still damp, I would recommend just blasting it with a hairdryer. They are heatless curls, so ideally we don't want to use heat on them, but even if you're just blasting it with a hairdryer for a few minutes, it's less heat damage than it would be if you were using a styling tool. Okay, anyway, I'm going to stop blabbering and let's actually start. And I try to keep these sections pretty even, but I'm going to go in with my little face frame here and I'm just going to wrap it round. And as I wrap it round, you want to grab another bit to join it with at the front, like that, keeping it nice and tight, which is exactly what your clip's going to help you do. Just slowly grab your pieces of hair as you go around, and I will just do this in real time with you guys so you can see. And I'm just grabbing from the back using both my hands, so grabbing a section from the back, coming back around. As I'm coming back around, I'm also grabbing a section from the front. So I'm making sure that the back is curled, because a lot of you are kind of asking like, what does the back look like? My back is always just as curly as the front. I've done a few videos to show you that, but this is a great tip. Grab from the back, and as you come around the front, grab the whole lot with your thumb and wrap it back round. And we're just gonna keep going round like this. Just grab and go, and obviously the bits are going to get bigger as you go, but just try and make sure that you're keeping the sections even. Otherwise, you are going to have some curls bigger than the other, and that just means that they will drop out at different rates throughout the day, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it's my preference. I prefer them all to kind of be the same. And just as you get to this bit, make sure it's nice and tight, because you're going to want it to really stay close to your head and not sit too far out. So, and then this is the fun part, because you literally just wrap it round and keep this really tight, because you're gonna want the ends to be super cute and curly. So just wrap and go. And honestly, when you've done this a few times, it becomes so easy. It's like second nature. And as you can see, that literally took me, I think, less than 2 minutes to wrap that one side. So it's probably less than 5 minutes in total to do the lot. And then hold it nice and tight, grabbing your scrunchie, wrap it round and make sure that this is tight because obviously you don't want it to fall out. And that is what one side is looking like. Obviously, as it's only taking me 2 minutes, if you find that it's not tight enough or it drops out as you let go, unwind it and wrap it up again. It's honestly not that big a deal if you do get it wrong first time. It has taken me a few tries to kind of get this right, but now it does just feel like second nature. And we're just gonna go ahead and do the exact same to the other side. And I'm just grabbing as I go. I think the first few sections are mainly just from the front that I grab. And then I think about 3 or 4 sections in, I do start grabbing from the back just to make sure, because obviously I want my face frame to be nice and tight. And then I can start grabbing from the back once I've prioritized that. So yeah, about here, just above the ear, just before you get to your ear, just start including some sections from the back and just grab and go. And it is honestly, I find it so easy. A lot of people kind of ask me what it's like to sleep in. Personally, I do like sleeping on my back, but I am also a sucker for side sleeping. Like, I find it so comfortable to curl over onto my side. And I just find, you know, you've got a bit of a speed bump. Once you turn over the speed bump, you're just as comfortable. Like, it's gonna be different for anyone, obviously. It takes a little bit of getting used to, but I have also done it with dressing gown curls. And I wouldn't say they're too different. It's obviously just slightly less noticeable if you're rolling around and stuff. But if you're a back sleeper on your back, this won't affect you at all. If you are a side sleeper, it just takes a little bit of getting used to. But once you just roll over that speed bump, it almost holds you in place. And I find I actually sleep better because it makes me lie still, because I can be a bit of a fidget. So, and we're just making sure again on the ends that this bit is nice and tight, and I've got my scrunchie all ready to go, and just wrap it as tight as you can. And we're all in, obviously. Just remove your clip before you go to bed. So now we are all done. Before I go to bed, obviously, because I said that I wanted your hair to almost completely dry down, what you probably find is the first part of your hair that dry is the front bit, and we want these to be nice and tight and curly as well. So I will just dampen it with a leave-in conditioner. I don't think it really matters what you do, but try not to use something too oily, because I find if I use something too oily, the curls just slip out and they just like open up and they just drop out very, very quickly because your hair is super slippy. It doesn't grab as much. So just dampen it with something like a heat defense spray or a leave-in conditioner. Heat defense spray is actually what I'm using, and I think it might work better because it's less oily and it's less likely to make your hair super soft. Wait till your curls come out and then you can put a load of oil through them and it makes them just as beautiful. So I would probably head off to bed now, go to sleep, have a nice long night's sleep. And if it is damp in the morning, I might give it a little bit of a blast with a hairdryer, but not too much. So I will head off now and I will show you the results when this is all dried down. Guess who's back? It's been a few hours now and I've kind of let everything dry down. Obviously, if I was sleeping, it would be a lot longer. So the curls are probably going to be a lot tighter. But this actually is perfect for when you're about to go out and you just kind of pop in your hair, spritz it all down. I mean, mine was still slightly damp from last night, so hopefully, fingers crossed. But as you can see, this side has dropped out slightly more, which is actually more likely to happen when you sleep. But obviously, I've been like moving around doing a load of stuff. And just a quick tip, we are obviously going to spray it with hairspray when we are done. But if you just do a light little coating before you remove them and then give that, why is that spraying literally everywhere? Then give that a minute to kind of dry down before you take them out. And now let's remove. I actually love this part. I find this so satisfying. Like I said, if I'd have slept in them slightly more damp, they'd have had more hours to kind of curl. So these are probably going to be more like a cute little blowout, but I do love that for when you're like going out, just having a cute little blowout. And obviously, as you can see, it's so ridiculously easy to just remove. That's also credit to actually brushing your hair through, because as you saw on that side, it got slightly more stuck. That's just because it was slightly knotted around the thing. Just give these an initial spritz down as they are out before we shake them out. And now I will just gently start to unravel and detangle. And they tend to just kind of sit where you leave them. Just get out the little face frame bit. And that is literally how ridiculously easy it is to get your curls out in the morning, which is why I adore them. Obviously, like I said, these are going to be kind of softer, more subtle curls because I haven't left them in for as long because I haven't slept in them. If you go onto my YouTube, you will see loads of other videos of my hair and just how cute they are. But you can kind of see just how quick and easy. And then let's just show you from the back, because so many people obviously are concerned that it doesn't curl as well at the back. But I find that this works brilliantly because obviously we wrapped it all in. But yeah, these are just so cute, so easy, and I probably left them in for a few hours just while I got ready and did some bits. So if you are heading out, you can just pop your heatless curls in, spritz it all down, get ready, do your makeup, have some drinks with the girlfriends and do them, or you can leave them in overnight to have really tight, beautiful curls in the morning. And that was just my super quick, easy tutorial for how I get my everyday heatless curls. It's absolutely my favorite and I hope that helped. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I will catch you in my next video. Love ya!